interesting topic. 1911, famous scientist Kamerling Ohms is Nobel laureate. He was awarded Nobel Prize. Kamerling Ohms found that resistance of mercury becomes zero when it is cooled below 4 degree Kelvin or Kelvin. In general, for many materials, for most materials, resistance decreases when temperature is decreased. Resistance not only decreases, but resistance becomes absolutely zero, clean zero, not nearly zero. In some books, it is called nearly zero, it is not correct. So, for many materials, resistance becomes zero, precisely zero, when cooled below a certain temperature Tc. This Tc is called critical temperature. काही material गार केल्यानंतर विशिष्ट टेम्परेचरला त्याचा रेजिस्टन्स झिरो होतो. हे जे टेम्परेचर टीसी आहे त्याला म्हणलंय क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर. रेजिस्टन्स झिरो हा एक चमत्कार आहे म्हणलं तरी चालेल. रेजिस्टन्स झिरो म्हणजे काय? देयर इज नो ऑपोजिशन टू द फ्लो ऑफ करंट, सो करंट कॅन फ्लो इझिली. इलेक्ट्रिक करंटला काहीच एनर्जी लागणार नाहीये, करंट फ्लोच नाहीये, रेजिस्टन्सच नाहीये. सो वन्स इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज सेट अप, to set up the electric current, battery will be required. Resistance is zero, so current can be thousands of ampere. And now you remove that battery. After battery, kaadun takli zari to 100 ampere, 1000 ampere current, the conductor will be anar hai. To kalis kami onar nahi hai. Current resistance zero hai, opposition nahi hai. So current can persist for a long time. Long time means how long? For several years. Indefinitely. So in this way, current can persist in a conductor, huge current, 100 ampere, 1000 ampere, can persist in a conductor even if the battery is removed. That means without requiring energy. Superconductor. This is called superconductivity. Resistance becomes zero, so large current can persist for a very long time, several years, without requiring source of EMF, without requiring any energy. This is called superconductivity. Normal conductivity and superconductivity are different. Quite different. The reason is, excellent conductors like copper or silver, they never become superconductor. Even if copper is cold, to any low temperature, it never becomes superconductor. On the other hand, there are many ceramic materials which become superconductor, but at ordinary temperature, they are excellent insulators. अनेक सिरॅमिक मटेरियल आहेत, ते नेहमीच्या टेम्परेचरला बॅड कंडक्टर आहेत, इन्सुलेटर आहेत, पण विशिष्ट टेम्परेचरला गार केल्यानंतर मात्र त्याचा रेजिस्टन्स झिरो होतो, सुपर कंडक्टर. याच्यावर लक्षात घेत की कंडक्टिव्हिटी आणि सुपर कंडक्टिव्हिटी या दोन्ही अगदी वेगळ्या गोष्टी आहेत. लुक ॲट दीज ग्राफ्स, ग्राफ ऑफ रेजिस्टिव्हिटी रो अगेन्स्ट टेम्परेचर टी. सी द ग्राफ फ्रॉम for decreasing temperature. For a normal material, when temperature is decreasing, resistance decreases. Resistance goes on decreasing, but it never becomes zero. Even though temperature is zero, resistance is there. This is normal material. Now look at the graph for superconductor. Resistance, when material is cooled, resistance goes on decreasing, 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 and at some temperature, the resistance suddenly becomes zero. Here, you can see that resistance suddenly drops to zero. This is superconductor. Superconductivity has many applications, very useful applications. For power transmission from generating station to city, if we use superconductor, there will be no loss of energy, no loss of electric power. Very useful. I have given here many applications, you can see easily. Very fast computer switches can be obtained with the help of superconductors. Very powerful magnets used for material science can be obtained using superconductor. तर superconductor मध्ये आता तरी एकच अडचण आहे, त्याला अनेक ऍप्लिकेशन्स आहेत. आता तरी एकच अडचण आहे की superconductivity ही फार लो टेम्परेचर जायला लागतं, आपल्याला ऍब्सोल्यूट झिरो जायला लागतं. सायंटिस्ट नवीन नवीन मटेरियल शोधायच्या प्रयत्नात आहेत आणि आता तरी superconductivity 160 केल्विन, नॉर्मल टेम्परेचर काय 273 केल्विन, एवढं फुल केलं की आपल्याला सुपर कंडक्टर मिळतो. पण येत्या 5-10 वर्षात असं काही मटेरियल तयार होईल की जे रूम टेम्परेचर सुपर कंडक्टर आहे आणि आपल्याला अनेक चमत्कार पाहायला मिळतील. विल हॅव मेनी मेनी इंटरेस्टिंग ऍप्लिकेशन. I think this is enough for today. In our next lecture, I'll tell you much more useful things about electricity. Not only that, we'll solve problems. Goodbye till that.